In this video, we are going to ask ChatGPT to create this animation for us. We will see if we can ask AI to give us After Effects expressions to animate this nice text logo. I am in After Effects, and to start animating this, I'm going to use this word in here, and each letter is separated on a different layer right over here. So, and I'm going to ask ChatGPT to create animations for us, which we can apply to each individual letter. So let's start with this O in here of motion, and I'm going to go to ChatGPT, and I'm going to ask it to create an After Effects expression that oscillates the position up and down by 500 pixels. The animation then slowly dies down and the object comes to its original position. Let's see what it creates. And it gives us this expression. So let's copy this code and see what it does. To paste your code, you need to hit P on your keyboard to open the position property, and then hold Alt on your keyboard and click the stopwatch to open the expressions properties. And I'm going to paste it right over here. So Control V to paste it. And great, immediately you can see that this has worked immediately for us. Brilliant, it looks very nice. And if I go in it, I can see that I have also a decay option in here, which I can increase. For instance, if I change that to 6, I think it should decay faster, as you can see. Perfect, and this looks really, really nice. So let's make this to around 5, the decay, and frequency and amplitude, I quite like it, so I'm going to leave it like that. Great. So that works really well. Now let's ask it to create another expression for us. Let's see if we would like to scale this in smoothly. So let's ask ChatGPT to create that. I have told it to create an expression to scale in an object from scale 0,0 to scale 100,100 smoothly over time of 1 second. Let's see what it creates. And it has come up with this nice expression here. Let's see what it does if I copy the code in here. Hold Alt on your keyboard and click on the stopwatch and paste it right over here. And it has given us this error in here. And sometimes this happens. In that case, you can ask it in different wording and see if you can get a correct response. So let's do that. I am back in ChatGPT and I told it to create an After Effects expression that scales up an object from this value to this value over the time of 1 second. Let's see what it does. And it has given us this expression. This looks more promising, so let's copy the code, go back to After Effects and change it with this expression. As you can see, this works really great. Now, with this done, we can move to another letter. So let's go to this O, and I'm going to use the same expression exactly that we have used for this one, but tweak it very slightly. To do this, I'm not going to use ChatGPT, but I'm going to use this same expression. So Command-C on my keyboard, go to this one and open up scale, S for scale, hold Option or Alt plus click, and then paste it right over here. This will scale that in like that for us. Now, what I would like to do is I would actually would like to scale it only in the Y axis and not in the X axis. So in that case, in here we have the values. So this is the X value and this is the Y value. So X and Y. So I would like it to start with an X that is already 100. So it starts wide already. Now this way we are only affecting the Y, as you can see. So the Y is 0 and it goes to 100. And I can see what it does like this. Perfect. So that's really great. I would like to give it like a jumping animation as well, this one. So I'm going to copy from the position property of this one. I'm going to copy this expression, Control C on my keyboard, paste it over the position property of this one. Hold Option and click and paste it right over here. So Command C, V to paste, and there we go. Now I'm going to change the amplitude in here to the negative, minus 500, so that it comes from the top rather than from the bottom. And I can even increase this to something like 1000. Now, as you can see, this one comes from the top, like that. Great. Now let's animate the eye. For the eye, I'm simply going to use the same scale expression that we have created before. So let's hit S on this one, copy this, Control C, go to eye, and Let's close this, hit S on this, and open the property, the expression properties of this, and paste that expression over here. And as you can see, it is opening up very nicely in there. Wonderful. One thing that we can do is maybe move this anchor point to, for instance, the top in here. So let's pick this up. And if I hold Control on my keyboard, I can move the anchor point to the top. And this way it will open from the top like that. And I quite like this animation, so I'm going to do the same animation, but for the T in here. So Command C on my keyboard, or even you can copy the whole scale property in here. Go on T, hit S for scale and paste it right over here. And immediately you can see that they are animated the same way. The only difference in this case, I'm going to move the anchor point in here to the bottom. Pick the anchor point tool from here and hold Control on your keyboard so that we snap to the bottom like that. Now I have this nice animation. Now it would be nice if the T animates before the I. I'm going to drag I to a later stage in here, something like this. Maybe I go inside of the expression here. In here, ChatGPT, as you can see, have created us a feature to time to scale in here. We can maybe increase that to 2 so that it takes longer to scale in. Great. So now we need to animate the M and the N, and I would like to animate these using a position expression. First, I'm going to use a scale expression to scale it up. And I'm going to use exactly the same scale expression as we are using for this one. But then we can add the position expression that will make it look quite cool. So let's see how we can do that. Let's first use the scale expression and Control C on my keyboard, copy. Let's go to the M in here, open the scale property, Alt and click on the stopwatch and paste this right over here. Now you can see that M opening up with that scale. I'm going to move the anchor point once again of this one to the top. So let's pick the anchor point tool and hold Control on the keyboard so that we can snap and snap it to the top like that. And if I preview that, it looks like this, very nice. But in this case, I would like it to move from the right to the left of the screen. So I have asked ChatGPT to create an After Effects expression to animate the position of an object from right to left by a value of 500. The object needs to end in its original position, and then the animation needs to happen over 1 second. It gives us this expression. Let's see what this does. Let's copy this code. If we go to the position property, open that up, P, hold Option on your keyboard and click, and paste it right over there. And wonderful, this works really well. As you can see, it's animating over 1 second in here. As you can see, it is also using the linear expression in here. We can change it to an ease expression by simply saying changing linear to an ease. We can ask ChatGPT for this, but of course we can even do it ourselves. So in this case, I'm changing this to ease, and this should now become smoother like that. Great. And one more thing is that it is having panning over 1 second. If we would like that to happen more quickly, we can tweak that 1 second value that we gave it before to something like, for instance, 0.5. So it's right over here, as you can see. And let's try that. Wonderful. So maybe now it's too fast, so let's do that to something like 0.7. Really nice. Now I can do the same for the N in here. So I'm going to simply copy this expression and go to P on my keyboard, open the position property of that N, enter inside the position property and paste it right over there. Great, now that's coming in as well, and I'm going to do a scale. Now for this scale animation, we can use the same bounce expression that we were using for this one that we created with ChatGPT. So let's go to P for position, open this up, and I'm going to copy this whole thing in here. Control C on my keyboard, and let's open the scale, Alt click on the stopwatch, and I'm going to paste this expression over the scale of this object. And great, this gives quite a nice effect, as you can see. and we can make this the amplitude of this maybe 1000 so that it's even more exaggerated. And this looks quite nice. If you don't want to go through the hassle of asking it each time for an animation, we have created this very nice plugin that you can use to add animations to your letters. This specific plugin comes with 2000 different animations, and let's see very quickly how we can use this. So I have this the same word in here, motion. I'm going to pick all of those letters in there. I'm going to give it an animation. So I'm going to go to in and out animations from here and go to something like position and scale right over here. And I'm going to simply pick a simple one, a jump scale animation, and add it to the in of the layer. You can also add it to the out to transition the object out. So let's add it in just like that. You can see that whole object bouncing all together in there. Another fun thing that this plugin can do is that it has this very nice toolbar up here, which with it we can stagger, for instance, layers forward. So if we pick all of these letters, pick them all up and stagger the layers forward like this, maybe two frames, and let's preview. Now, as you can see, you have this very nice animation that we have done literally in a few seconds in here. So feel free to check this out. I'm going to leave a link in the description below, and with it you can get 20 free presets to start you off and also have access to some of the features of the toolbar right over here. I quite like how this animation is looking, but one final thing that we can do is we can add color. To add color to this, it is very, very simple. So now let's pick all these layers and I'm simply going to pre-compose them. So layer and pre-compose, motion animation, and I'm simply going to click OK. Now let's jump back to the previous composition here. I'm going to duplicate this, Control D on your keyboard. I'm going to use a simple fill effect from here. So type in fill from effects and presets and drag and drop it right over here. If you move it this by two frames, you can see this takes the color of that fill effect. I'm going to change that color to something like this, and I'm going to duplicate this one more time, Control D on your keyboard, move it by another two frames and give it a new color, something like this. Hit OK. And let's see how this looks. What we can do is only move it by one frame instead of two. Let's see how this looks. So as you can see, this was created using only expressions that we get from ChatGPT. And this looks quite cool. So that is it, guys. Go ahead and try to ask ChatGPT yourselves, and maybe let us know in the comment section below how it went. Of course, make sure to subscribe to our channel, where we will be releasing more videos weekly. And maybe leave a thumbs up. This really helps us to create more content for you. Thank you very much for watching.